Hello everyone, welcome back to the WayKen Rapid Manufacturing channel. I'm Lingo. When it comes to plastic parts, from design validation to low volume pre-production, how can we improve efficiency while controlling costs? Urethane casting, with its fast replication, high fidelity, and low unit cost, has become the ideal bridge between prototyping and mass production. Here in my hand is a plastic housing part made using the urethane casting process. This customer typically needs 50 to 100 pieces per batch, and the parts require surface texturing, logo printing, and lettering. So why is urethane casting the best fit for this project? Compared to CNC machining, urethane casting offers a clear cost advantage. CNC is often expensive and time-consuming, especially for complex plastic parts. In contrast, casting only requires a single silicon mold to quickly replicate dozens or even hundreds of parts, significantly saving both time and budget. 3D printing is fast, but it falls short in terms of strength, surface finish, and fine detail. Printed parts may lack good texture, clarity, or paintability. Injection molding is of course ideal for high volume production, but mold fabrication alone takes 3 to 4 weeks or more, with costs ranging from tens of thousands of RMB. This is exactly where urethane casting shines. With only one master pattern and a few silicon molds, you can replicate dozens or even hundreds of high quality plastic parts within a matter of days. The key to urethane casting lies in making a high-quality master pattern. When tight dimensional tolerances and the smooth surfaces are required, we typically use CNC machining with ABS material to make the master pattern. For more complex geometries and detailed structures, SLA 3D printing is preferred. The master pattern then goes through necessary surface treatments to ensure a clean, smooth finish. Next, the master pattern will be placed into a mold frame and the liquid silicone is poured in. The mold is vacuum degassed to remove air bubbles and then left to cure. Once cured, the mold will be carefully cut open and the master pattern is removed. This results in a flexible silicon mold that can be reused. Then comes the casting process. PU resin is injected into the silicon mold under vacuum. After the material cures, the finished part is removed from the mold. The cast parts then go through post-processing based on specific requirements to make sure both appearance and the function meet the customer's expectations. Thanks for watching. Be sure to follow us at WayKen to explore more insights into manufacturing processes.